businesses. And I do that with the goal of helping them profit from Bitcoin or blockchain technologies. And I do that by basically introducing them to Komodo flexibility and also the Komodo's tools that we offer. I also connect some people and ideas like that. And today I'm going to be talking about atomic swaps and decentralized exchanges. John, in his other talk, already mentioned that there's a lot of things related to security troubles. And one of the biggest advantages, I think, and it's going to probably bring people into using atomic swaps more now that they're able, they're easily usable, is security. So the security aspect, John mentioned some features there, so I'll basically leave it at that. There's a lot of hacks, and a lot of hacks come from hackers attacking large sums of funds. And in this case, maybe centralized exchanges. And there's been billions of dollars stolen from centralized exchanges. And because it's very easy, not an easy target, I mean, they have that security, but they're worth putting some effort to hack. There's a lot of funds in there. And that's one of the things that I'd like you to look at about the security features here. So, who is Komodo to talk about atomic swaps? Well, we've been working on atomic swaps since 2014, more than half a decade now. Our founder and lead dev, James Lee, he collaborated with the person who first came up with the idea of atomic swaps. In 2016, he made the first fully automated atomic swap, and we've continued development since then. I mean, we have a lot of nice slides now, but this is kind of a recent thing. I mean, we've been doing this for a long time and no one really knows us, because we've been actually working. Actually, recently, at the end of last year, in September, one of the things we did with the atomic swaps was we made the first pure browser-based atomic swap, exchanging between two different currencies using the secure browser environment. That has some pretty big implications for the future. I mean, that will shrink the size of the devices needed, and it will make it extremely easy. This is a test, but this is the steps we're taking. In December last year, we did the first Tezos Ethereum cross-chain atomic swap on our atomic deck software. So we're working with other projects and other people for our goal of interoperability between cross-chain and this is one of our tools for interoperability between chains. I'll have this quote up at the end also. This will link to a list of things that I talk about. We don't have a lot of time and people can write better than I can talk anyhow. So if you would like to check anything I say tonight, there's some places you can start. So what's an atomic swap? An atomic swap is a secure and trustless exchange of digital assets. The atomic in the atomic swap means all or nothing. The swap goes through exactly as agreed upon by the two parties, or it doesn't go through and they walk out with what they started with. In the swap, the way it's organized now, the taker who takes the order, they will pay a fee, and that fee is 0.15%. It's basically to stop people spamming the network. I mentioned security. I'll show very, very briefly some of the things, but if you really want to know how the swap works, please ask after or check the documentation I put up. The security here. When you're doing an atomic swap, your private key will never leave your wallet. Your private key means your funds. The swap will go between your wallet and the blockchain. It's blockchain based. There's no third party and there's no counterparty risk. So, transparency. One of the things with this is a device to blockchain ledger transactions in these swaps. You can check on the blockchain explorer for yourself and see the transactions. You can follow them too. That's part of the useful part of it. So this is a bit of an order. It looks very simple here, and the actual process is very simple. As you would imagine, there's a lot going on in the background. Otherwise, other people would be able to do this. This is a true atomic swap. So at no point in this process, it has four transactions, at no point do your funds ever leave your control. So when we do these swaps here, there's a little bit of magic. It's not cryptographic, but it's based on really old and proven battle-tested technology. This is not new technology, it's not some magic actually. It's based on some pretty old technologies from 2015. They were introduced into Bitcoin in the BIP, the Bitcoin Improving Process, in late October 2015. Time-locked hash and hash-locked. Time-locked and hash-locked. I'm a bit out of sorts here. So it's based on these old Bitcoin technologies, and through this, as the swap's going through, it'll be sent to a hash-locked wallet. And at any time, if the other party, for example, gets all excited and drops their phone in the toilet, and they can't complete their side of the swap, when the time lock expires, the funds will return to the originating wallet. It's the same on both sides. It goes straight to the blockchain. There's no money in the middle. So that has some pretty big implications. We're able to do these swaps with Bitcoin-based protocols and also ERC20 Ethereum-based protocols. And like I mentioned before, we're integrating other ones if they want. For example, in case of I had this already, and I did something to it, and now it's just gone. So what we'll do now, we'll move on to the decentralized exchange. So this is the atomic swap, and it's pretty important for that. There's many, we say decentralized exchanges, but when you think of a decentralized exchange, these are three points that I would highly recommend considering. If you need a real decentralized exchange. So these three points here are something you might want to consider very carefully. What is a real decentralized exchange? Again, you can check the details about this afterwards in the documentation. So one of the things about this is with a decentralized exchange like this, I mean, we have a mobile decentralized exchange in our wallet, and that's pretty new. This is the kind of new thing that we've got now, that we've been working towards. And it's going to be one of the things that we think is going to really bring in a lot of users to atomic swap. It makes it very practical. And this is something that you can actually test out for yourself. I'll show you some pictures of it. But we're not saying that, we wouldn't really think that the decentralized exchange is replacing the centralized exchange anytime soon. It's a different tool for a different job, but one of the things we do see is a hybrid exchange, a centralized exchange that also incorporates atomic swaps, for security reasons probably. So we're talking about the exchanges now. The decentralized exchange also has some challenges to it. And these are some of the ways that we've addressed this. And you can see them inside the AtomicX software. The difficult to use user interface, and I mean, this is what it looks like. And you can actually try this out for yourself, probably on the way home if you want to. You can download it from the App Store, Google Play. Try. If you need test coins, just let me know. One of the things that was really troublesome in our second generation one, this information comes from our second generation product. Atomic Mix is the third generation. The second generation Atomic, it's called Larder Dex. The second generation Dex, we have over 115,000 swaps while it was open. And these are live, real swaps that between people exchanging their funds. But we asked what we got a lot of feedback from that time, and that was the number one. This is number two, the liquidity. And so we've come up with a few ideas for dealing with that problem. And what we have here is a shared liquidity pool. Under the GUI here, the mobile app, there's some market maker software. And one thing I should point out is that this is not an exchange run by Komodo. It's a non-hosted, non-custodial wallet software. It's open source, free to use. It's also a white label. The underlying market maker software is a white label product. Anyone can build their own Atomic Dex. And actually, some of our ecosystem projects are working on that. One of them is called the Hyper Dex. And what they share with liquidity pool is, for example, if I place an order on my Atomic Dex wallet and someone places one on their Hyper Dex wallet, we can see each other's orders in this shared liquidity. Komodo is not interested in making these apps. That's not really what we do. But during the BarterDex experience, we had the second generation experience. We found that people didn't understand. No one came to build many apps. There was two or three people building on top of this. We don't want to build this. We want to build the base, the platform, the technology that makes it possible. Have other people come and build on top of it. One of the other things we have here that we're looking to deal with liquidity issues is something called the liquidity multiplication. And what that is, for example, if you have like one Bitcoin, if you want to make a trade, you can put that one Bitcoin up against one Bitcoin worth of Ethereum. That's how it normally is in everything. We think that kind of locks in some funds, or it's, some people, they want to fund. Pardon me, they want to make more pairs. So what the liquidity multiplication does, you can also put that one Bitcoin up against a different pair. For example, you could make your one Bitcoin, one Ethereum pair. You can make it up against Dash. You could make a pair against Litecoin, against Komodo. And what will happen is someone hits one of your orders, say they hit your order for half a Komodo, or half a Bitcoin with a Komodo, it'll take the other orders down. Also with that, if you have an advanced enough bot, you can adjust that so they don't go, they just don't drop all the orders, they just adjust to the difference. So this is quite a useful feature for people wanting to trade or put up our bots. What we have here is a central exchange order book mirroring. And what that is you can pull the price feed from your centralized exchange, central exchange account. For example, maybe Binance or something. Use your API key from Binance and you can get your price feeds from there. And you can make an arbitrage bot from that, set your margin. Other things that might do, if you have an advanced bot, you could search for unmatched orders, check your price feeds, and see if you want to make a pair for it, if you could fill that order. For this one here, the market makers pay no fees. We have a very low fee, like I said before, for the taker, 0.15%. Basically, this stops spamming. If you use Komodo as one of your pairs, you get a slightly lower fee, but you can swap against anything. I went through very quickly, but on the previous slide with the 3 points, one of the things that makes a true DEX is asset agnostic. What that means is that any pair can trade against, or any coin can trade against any other listed coin. There's not many, a centralized exchange doesn't do that for many reasons, but on a decentralized exchange like this, you can. Let's see here. So this is Atomic Dex here, and this is the mobile app, pretty easy to use. Try it out if you want to and get test coins. This is the one I want to talk about right here. Atomic swap technology can be built into any product. the kind of thing that I'm interested in, and we're interested in, for you to come and do. Some of the things might be fairly easy, some are definitely not. They'll take a lot of work. But that's what we want to do. And the things we talked about before, I'll get on to in a few minutes. And think about, I heard someone mention an ATM machine before. You don't need to hold all the coins in it, you can have 100 options there. Things like that. And this is the part also that really interests me. I mean, we've been doing atomic swaps and working on this for more than half a decade now. We've had doing an atomic swap on a decentralized exchange, been there, done that. The mobile aspect of this is really cool. It's very nice, and I think that'll be very powerful for bringing people in. But this is the future here, and this is what we're working on. And, I was going to say too, the tech stack for this is quite new too from the previous one. This is where it's going, and there's a lot of documentation on Komodo, and it's quite big. This is a very small part of the big part, I guess. This is a big part of what we actually do. But if you have a look into it and you do your research, you can see the clear stepping stones and the pieces of technology that we've done and are working on, and you can see them being worked on for this. I already talked a little bit about the browser-based atomic swap, and that's something we're thinking about, the power of that. The Superlight atomic swap is based on the NSPV technology that we've developed in the last 6 months or so. And things go pretty fast. I mean, that's fairly old now. It's a super lightweight wallet. These kind of things here are what we're looking for in the future. I don't think other people are thinking about what's after SPV. What's going to happen? I mean, we've already got the wallet for that. And this has some implications for IoT or IoT also. I mean, you can build this stuff in, like you mentioned, an ATM machine, a POS thing. I'm not saying this is easy, but I am saying it's possible. It's technically possible for the right people to be able to do that. These ones are very interesting. You might have seen these. We have an ecosystem. We have some other projects that build on our platform. And two of them here are interested in privacy. Komodo doesn't have a privacy feature in it, but when you spin up a smart chain on our platform, you can choose your level of privacy using the ZK SNARKs. We're a fork from Zcash. These two projects are working on something that will be very, very, very interesting, and that's the privacy-enabled atomic swaps. That's a shielded atomic swap. And that has some pretty big implications. And I mean, the option of privacy, I mean, that's essential for our business or government or people. Have that option. They're working towards this. This one here is like the holy grail of atomic swaps. It's a light, meaning no blockchain downloaded, mobile Z transaction, shielded transaction. Well, you can look at the steps that we've been going through and the technology we're building and how some of these projects, Pirate and Hush, are working towards this. The last one here is the external blockchain platform integration. We're an open source project with people all over the world. And one of our fundamental principles is blockchain chain adoption and interoperability. I have an invitation for you guys. We'd like people to use our technology. It's free, it's open source, and it's very, very powerful. You can use it for making money, you can use use it for changing the world. You can use it with us or without us. You can just take it and do it. You're welcome to join. So I talked about a little bit about atomic swaps, a little bit about decentralized exchanges. And I mean, when you think about the implications and that you can use for your business or you can use for your project, they're pretty big. But that's only one thing that we have. This is one piece. It's very popular now. There's many hexes. But if you look at those points I showed you, please look into it. And I think a token-based one, or only trading on a single platform, this is one thing. We have a lot more than that.